Hey guys, so the coronavirus has hit us, Singapore, already and has already spread across the world. But in terms of the property market, do Singaporeans know what's going on? And what are some of the things that we can actually pick up from history? So firstly, if we look at coronavirus as an outbreak, it was pretty much similar to previous two, which was SARS and the H1N1 swine flu. So in these two cases, how did the property market behave, and what were the results of the people who bought property during the outbreaks period? Looking at the chart now, you realize that a lot of the both situations in 2003, the SARS period, and the swine flu, H1N1 2009 period, people were buying new launches as well. However, they were buying it at lower prices. So what happened is, after they buying it at lower prices, right, the prices start to recover as soon as the virus situation improved. So in a certain sense, you and me, we are now in the coronavirus, or rather the COVID-19 situation. Do you think it will recover? How long will it take to recover? And would you buy a property when the situation is over, when the sentiment goes back, or would you buy now when the prices are still remaining very low? That's your choice. However, I want to empower you guys with more information and facts and figures instead of just saying, oh, buy now. So firstly, we look at some of the examples. One of it is this. During the SARS period, there was a new launch. It was called the Icon at Goping. So this is a condominium right smack in the middle of the central business district. The highest profit, they bought it in June 2003, which was right at the end of the SARS period. The last patient was in May 2003. This buyer made a profit of $1.04 million when buying during the SARS period. One more example for you, if you don't believe, was during the H1N1 swine flu period. There's this condo. It's called the River Gate. It's also along the Singapore River in the core central region of Singapore. The buyer bought it at in 2009 in June and realized a profit of May 2009. He bought it and sold it off at a profit of $1.7 million Singapore dollars. That would be an annualized profit of 31% per year. Can you imagine if you would enter in such a low period, and when the market recovers, you would already have seen the rebound, you would already have been making appreciation of the rebound. So looking at Rivergate as a purchase, right, this buyer who sold off at a profit of $1.7 million is actually selling it at, the profit is actually at 10 times the Singapore's inflation rate, if you put Singapore's inflation rate at 3%. And annualized growth of 31% is huge, it's 10 times more. So would you buy during a coronavirus outbreak, or would you not buy and wait until the market recovers and then you buy? So guys, if you are interested to know more about how the coronavirus affects the property market today and whether you should buy or not buy today, please, I'm Edison Lian, contact me, call me or text me. And in the meanwhile, I wish you all the best of health and see you soon.